faith we see the hand of God. In the light of creation's grand design. In the lives of those who prove his faithfulness. Who walk by faith and not by sight.
Good morning and welcome to the Jester ARP Church Devotional Podcast. Hey, I'm Clint Davis. Thank you so much for joining us. We're delighted that you are with us as we think about reading the Bible and discussing it. In particular, we're thinking about the book of Philippians. We turn our attention to Philippians chapter 1, verse 12, and what follows. This is the Apostle Paul talking about the chains that he is currently enduring for the sake and the advance of the gospel. He's locked up in prison under house arrest in Rome as he is writing to this church in Philippi. This is what the Apostle Paul says. Now, I want you to know, brothers and sisters, that what has happened to me has actually served to advance the gospel. As a result, it has become clear throughout all the whole palace guard and to everyone else that I am in chains for Christ. And because of my chains, most of the brothers and sisters have become confident in the Lord, and they're all the more to proclaim the gospel without fear. It is true that some preach Christ out of envy and rivalry, but others out of goodwill. The latter do so out of love, knowing that I am put here for the defense of the gospel. The former preach Christ out of selfish ambition, not sincerely, supposing that they can stir up trouble for me while I am in chains. But what does that matter? The important thing is that in every way, whether from false motives or true, Christ is preached. And because of this, I rejoice. Now, I want to stop right there at the kind of midway point of verse 18. Paul is writing to the church in Philippi. He's saying, I want you to know, brothers and sisters, that what has happened to me has actually served the advance of the gospel. Here you see Paul's great motivation. He is motivated by love for the church in Philippi. He adores them. He is praying for them. But he is also wanting them to understand that he is motivated to live his life for the sake of the gospel of Jesus Christ, for the advancement of the kingdom of God. If you're a Christian today, let me ask you, is that your goal? Do you process everything that happens to you in your life as a through the lens of how does this advance the kingdom of God? How does this enable me to grow in my relationship with Christ? How does this enable me to walk with Jesus and testify to his glory? How does this enable me to love God more and to see God's hand at work in my life and so as to advance the gospel? I mean, Paul is unfairly arrested in the end of the book of Acts. He's taken to Rome. He's sitting in prison. And while he is there, he is being guarded every day, day and night, by the palace guard, the greatest and the best soldiers that Caesar has. And he's under house arrest. He can't come and go as he freely chooses. He's having to write letters to these people whom he loves and would love to be visiting them. And he says, hey, listen, this has advanced the gospel. It's been clear throughout the whole Praetorium Guard. Everybody who is coming understands why the Apostle Paul is in prison, and Paul is willing to tell them why he is in prison. You know, when I did some prison ministry before, and one of the things they say is don't ask them why they're in prison. And that's kind of the rule. But it's inevitable that you ask because your curiosity gets the best of you. And so people would ask Paul, but I'd get the impression Paul was just telling people, hey, listen, I'm in prison because I had the audacity to preach about Jesus, to tell people about Jesus, how he is the Savior of the world, how he is the one who has come and taken on flesh to live a perfect life and die a perfect death in my place and in your place, and you can trust him too. Because of my chains, most of the brothers and sisters, not only has Paul been testifying, but brothers and sisters have seen Paul in suffering, they have seen Paul in chains, and they've been more confident. Well, if that happened to Paul, and he can endure, I can too. And so they are more bold in proclaiming the good news of Christ. And yes, it's true that as a result of that, some people tried to seize the opportunity to run Paul down, to take advantage of him out of envy and rivalry and they wanted to, out of selfish ambition, they wanted to pick at Paul. And so they would tell the story of Jesus. But Paul says, so what? The gospel's going out. People are hearing the story and God can work through that. And then there are those who are doing it out of the best motives possible. They want to see people come to Christ. They want to see Jesus glorified. They want to see the gospel go out. And Paul says, yes, in every way, whatever the motive is, Christ is preached and I rejoice. Do you think of the circumstances in your life that way? Do you think of the situations around you that way? Do you think of the challenges to your faith that way, that these are opportunities to proclaim the good news of Jesus, and prayerfully, the gospel will go out. People will come to know Jesus, and they'll bring glory to his name. I hope you do, guys. Hey, you have a great day. God bless you. I'll catch up with you tomorrow. It's Thanksgiving week. We'll have a great week.